Welcome to gardenville.tv. Now we're out at the allotment, the famous Gardenville allotment, and if you're going to grow vegetables, you've got to be watching what Susan is doing in the allotment, how she plans it, the timing, everything that goes into growing vegetables that give you a real long season of eating vegetables.
That's the idea, Catherine, yeah, that you get something coming along all the time, and then there's things you repeat sowing, like your lettuces and various salads, things, crops like that.
So here we have Susan now. You've put in a number
I've put in a number of these broad beans.
Yeah.
You probably remember we sowed these back in March.
Yes.
Sowed them in little pots.
And it was a very windy day and we were in the polytunnel.
Yeah.
And the polytunnel nearly took off with us.
Yeah.
Okay.
So these
so here we are.
Because we've grown them in sort of small pots, they've got up to this size. So we're planting them out, and what you do is double rows. Approximately 9 inches between each, 6 to 9 inches between each bean in a double row.
Oh, and why do you do a double row?
Because then what you do is you can obviously pick from either side, but between each double row you leave a space of about 2 feet.
Yeah.
These grow quite tall. So
and do they need canes or anything to support them?
What we do is we put a couple of canes, or either a single cane at each double row and a piece of string around.
Oh,
to keep them from flopping over.
I see, okay. And why do you have to keep a division there in between both of these?
Well, you've got to get in to pick them, and they do grow.
Good
when
thinking.
You see when they grow, they grow quite big, so they need a bit of space to go.
Okay, right, okay. So, here you have now your...
Here I have my little bean.
Yeah.
It seems well rooted in the pot.
Yeah, okay. Now, how long has that taken to grow, Susan, approximately?
When did we sow these?
Beginning
second,
of March?
Second week in March, something like that.
So wow, haven't they really, like here we are now coming towards the 20th of April.
About 10 days, 2 weeks to germinate.
Right. So we're now the 20th of April, so this will give you an idea of, you know, when you're planning and timing things, what, you know, what time it takes to get them to this stage. And then you also, I presume, Susan, need them at this particular height to put them into the ground. You wouldn't put them in earlier, or...?
You could do, it just depends on what time
Okay,
stuff.
And that's all about allotment growing as well. When you're out working and everything and you're coming to your allotment, you can't have it all.
You can't, it's
absolutely
very hard
perfect.
To beat. You may not be free, there may be something going on. This one's quite well.
Now, this one is well grown.
This is in a smaller pot, so these are growing. To water these in
so
well.
So you're
now.
Giving about 9 inches, is it?
Approximately.
Yeah.
Very sort of approximately. I just want another 5 here to finish off this.
Okay. Here's another little friend. Do you recycle your little plastic pots here for
heavens,
potting?
Yes, these are on their 18th year at this stage.
Yeah.
Yeah, they have.
So they've always got you some value, not into the bin.
Oh heavens, no.
No.
There'll be runner bean seeds going into those now.
And do you need to clean them out, Susan, or anything? Or just in case of disease or anything? Or?
I generally don't bother.
Yeah. So there's no worry on that.
I've overspaced here a bit. I wasn't watching what I was doing. Never mind. They'll do just as well.
Amazing amount of growing that goes into these guys, isn't it? Just over the couple of weeks, like they take off. You had those now in a little greenhouse area.
I had them in one of those little
plastic
whoops.
Yeah.
Plastic tunnel-y thing. Plastic.
And of course there's great special offers on those plastic tunnel things. I actually saw them advertised in the paper. You know, there's big sales happening.
I've finished my row out, so we have three spare.
Right, three spare. So what can we do with them?
Well,
I'll grow them.
You grow them. There you go.
I'll grow them.
Take them home and grow
them.
And
you can come and film and see how I get on.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, okay, because I'm your real beta customer here now.
Yeah.
Who doesn't have a clue. So that's fantastic. So we're going to leave those.
We're going to leave those.
The whole bed set out.
Water them in well.
Yeah. And then next step will be what with these?
Next step will be when they get to a certain height, it will be putting something on to support them, so it's when the wind blows you don't have them
falling over.
I mean, you still collect beans, but you'll be down here.
And Susan, do they need any feeding or anything?
This soil now, it's the first year this soil has been growing a crop for 100 and something years, so they're fine.
This soil is absolutely
so next year we'll be, because these beds are slightly raised so we can get between them, we'll be mulching with manure and compost and things to keep the fertility going and to make the soil a little bit more friable.
Right. Isn't that great though, to be in an allotment and to have real natural soil.
Oh, I mean,
to know that this is really fresh.
There's 18 inches of topsoil here.
Which is, hasn't been touched
yeah,
for
hasn't
years.
It hasn't been touched for years. You were, before the allotment started, you could still see the original sort of spade ridges.
I was just thinking, our runner beans will probably turn into Jack and the Beanstalk. We'll come out next week and there'll be these
spot them, maybe.
Yeah. Great. Okay, we look forward to that. So keep an eye on our allotment. And if you're growing an allotment or you need any questions answered or whatever, because it's not easy starting off doing your own thing, do contact us at gardenville.tv. You can send us in an email, you can Twitter, you can come on our blog, you can come on our Facebook. We want you to join in and let us know how you're getting on with your growing.